here at the 18th European Conference with Mr. Ayman El-Talouni, representing UN Environment Ozone Action. And first of all, thank you so much for being here, for your contribution, your partnering and co-organizing this conference. And of course, we appreciate your efforts, not only in the conference, but in general on the projects that you're leading as International Partnership Coordinator. May I ask your point of view on the current situation and the efforts and the engagement that the Ozone Action is giving for the projects and development of this sector and also of the developing countries?
Yeah, thank you so much. And I would like to start by thanking our partners in this event, the Centro Studi Galileo, IIR, and the government of Italy as an auspicious for organizing this event frequently. This is the 18th round, and we are proud to be here for the 10th round, as I think, we believe, as UNEP, as partner in the organization. And I do believe that such event is very important to keep the momentum of finding long-term and sustainable solution and facilitate the experience exchange among different stakeholders, either at the government level or at the playing field level of different stakeholders and practitioners. Now, if we look at the quick snapshot on the industry of refrigeration and conditioning, including heat pumps as well, we will find that the industry witnessed dramatic changes over the last three decades. And especially the pace of development in the last 10 years is unprecedented in terms of different type of application, especially an alternative being offered to the market, as well as the new challenges that come with these type of alternatives. Now, with all these type of dynamics, the practitioners in the field, owners, decision makers at the procurement level, have always difficulties and confusion how to deal with all this wide list of shopping substance and materials being available in the market, and which one would be sustainable, which one would not. And within this context, there's a big role to the to both sides, the government side and the institution side. And there's another role for the industry from their corporate social responsibility policies. Because what's happening, what we are putting today is going to affect our future in a few years from now. And we would like to learn from the lessons of the Montreal Protocol over the last 30 years to avoid the double phase out. So we don't want to phase out substances today and then we again phase it out after 10 years. We have done this before in the Montreal Protocol. We moved from CFC to HCFC, and then from HCFC to HFCs. Now we are moving from HFCs. So let's make a sustainable move this time.
Thank you so much, Mr. El-Talouni, for this broad overview. And based on the challenges that you mentioned and all the efforts, of course, of UN, how would you describe how you are facing this and what is the role that you are playing in this special moment?
Yeah, thank you, Ms. Our core mandate is to provide services and support to more than 145 developing countries, or what they call Article 5 countries as per the Montreal Protocol definition. And within this core mandate, the type of services can be classified into two directions. One direction, which is the direct implementation of the projects at the national level, projects funded by what's so-called the Multilateral Fund of the Montreal Protocol, in order to phase out or phase down the controlled substance under the protocol. Now, this type of services include institutional setup, policies update, training and certification programs, as well as custom training and technological awareness information. Now, the other side of the service and the products that we are providing is the normative technical assistance services, where we are providing some kind of tools and products, awareness material to different types of stakeholders that can be used in advancing the technological selection, as well as minimizing emissions through promoting the good practices. And within this context, in the last 5 to 6 years, we started to shift the way of doing our service in terms of stop reinventing the wheel and producing products from scratch by trying to piggyback and build on the expertise available among international institutions. And this is where the portfolio of partnerships is created within the Ozone Action Program. And now we are proud to have a long a list of initiatives and products and partnership arrangement with the majority of key international associations. I can give quick example from our collaboration if we take it from west to east, starting from the US side, we have the ASHRAE, a very well-known institute. We are working with HRI also in North America, but they are working with them not in North America, working with them within their mandate as leading the Global Refrigerant Management Initiative, GRMI, in developing what's so called the refrigerant driving license. And this includes the collaboration with other institutes and centers around the globe, especially Europe, like the Centro Studio Galileo. If we move to Europe, we can find that we have relationship with EPE, European Partnership for Energy and Environment. Similarly, we are working with IIR on the cold chain sector and the technological advancement and awareness about the cold chain sector. And with ATF recently in the last 3 years in Italy to build certification model in some developing countries. Now going to the east side, we started to work with the Japanese side, like JARAIA. So this is just a quick example about the type of engagement that we are doing. And each product that we are tailoring or designing, we are making sure that it is usable for the size and capacities and institutional setups within Article 5 countries. Definitely, I cannot take a certification program in Europe like the FGAS and apply it as is in Article 5 countries in Africa or Latin America or Asia. But everything needs to be tailored to the local capacities and the national specifics. And this is where we have to continue and maintain this collaboration and this momentum.
Thank you so much, Mr. Eltaluni, for this overview, for your efforts in Ozone Action, and for participating in the conference.
Thanks a lot for the opportunity. I'm glad to be here and look forward to the next round.
Thank you.